Our next guest is Dr. Deepali Ambike. She is a pediatrician, passed out from BT Medical College and KM Hospital and Research Center. A passionate professor, worked at renowned institutes like D.Y. Patil, MIMER Medical College, Talegaon. Participated in various national medical education programs and workshops. She has published her papers on child obesity and various international conferences. Her area of interest are neonatology, child nutrition, HIV transmission to child from parents, and behavior problems in children. She is also a successful participant of I Am Awesome 3.
Okay, so by now everyone will be 100% awake, and because I'll be speaking more on the nutrition part and foods, so I think it will be very interesting. Basically, you all must be knowing the proverb, hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. But I would like to say that a hand that rocks a healthy cradle will rule the world. Already Dr. Shimpi and Ahuja ma'am have spoken to you about how a healthy woman and a healthy mind should be. So we can't underestimate that a healthy woman will only give birth to a healthy child, which I think always the gynecologist and the pediatrician will at least agree on this topic, because I haven't worked with Chalaka. Because basically when it's a healthy mom, the baby will be healthy. Okay, unfortunately, there could be situations where even if the mom is healthy, there could be certain unavoidable circumstances where the baby will be born with a very low birth weight, or it could be a premature baby. Okay, so these conditions like low birth weight and prematurity usually give rise to some hindrances in the growth of a baby. We'll speak a bit about normal growth first. A normal baby or a newborn, the newborn period is up to 28 days after a baby is born. And later on, till the age of 1 year, we call him as an infant. Between 1 to 3 years, it's a toddler. Okay, these are the terminologies used. So you should also know, because these are used widely in the this net and all, when you all will search for things. And then it's a preschool age group, a school-going child, and most important is the adolescent stage, a pre-adolescent and adolescent, and then it's an adult. So up to 18 years, even if it is not a pediatric age group, we still treat, because adolescents have also come under pediatric, though it is a little different, you can say they have health issues. So I'll be speaking little about everything. So basically, the brain growth is very fast during the first 1 year. So whatever the baby needs is already supplied by the good nature. Nature has developed something which is, I would say, it is amrut, and that is breast milk. So whatever a mother will feed the baby up to 1 year, or max if she can feed up to 2 years, it's welcome. But it's very difficult now in this age of competition, where the mom has to go outside and work, and it's very difficult to feed the baby continuously. But whenever the baby comes home or leaves for work, the mother can feed the baby and go. Why? And why is this so much important about breast milk? Because the nature has enriched the breast milk with all the important antibodies, the vitamins, maybe one or two may be lacking, which are made up by the supplements which the doctor gives you. But never ever deprive any child of breast milk, because that has got, you can say, the whole amount of strength is being given through the breast milk to fight against all sorts of infections, which are very, very common during the childhood. Up to 5 years of age group, there are many, many dreadful diseases, and most dreadful is acute dehydration. You know, whenever the baby has diarrhea, loose motions, vomiting, the baby is getting exposed to a wide range of foods. Once you start feeding the baby with different kinds of maybe homemade food also, we are preparing it hygienically, but there could be some breach maybe in preparing, or some problem the maid is preparing the food, or some other exposure to many food allergens, because many food allergies are also developing during this time. The baby is exposed to many, many new products. So there can be more prone for infections and loose motion. But if the baby is breastfed up to a certain age, like 1 year, all the antibodies, or you can say the good proteins, are derived from the breast milk, which will curtail the infection at a particular level, and the baby will not you can say, go to a serious problem. Okay, so that's the importance of breast milk, and plus all the important essential fatty acids and amino acids. This is very, very important for the brain growth as well as the physical growth. So I just stress the importance of breast milk, because there are many different notions about it, whether to feed the baby with breast milk or not. So I would still endorse that breast milk is best for the baby. And then comes the age when you are starting introducing various foods. So whenever new food is always introduced to the baby, it should be high in proteins. It should be also high in carbohydrates. Now just remove the notion from your mind that something like adult diet or nutrition is not applicable to a child. Child is a totally different, it's not a mini adult. Child is not a mini adult. The child is growing into an adult. The needs are more. The growth phase, not only the growth phase, there are many hormonal changes which are going to go in the baby's, the kid's body at a certain age. So the baby, the child's body should be able to face all the problems or the hormonal situations or imbalances going to be faced in the pre-adolescent stage. So the needs are continuously increasing. So the meal should be balanced in such a way that at least 60% should be proteins, 30% should be carbohydrate, and 10% should be essential fatty acids. So we'll just go one by one. Proteins, okay, if you are a non-vegetarian, very good. You can go for a non-veg diet, but not before the age of 1 year, because there are again allergies. Egg albumin allergy, egg ka jo white hota hai, egg ka white, uska allergy bahut children, many children face this. So that is called as egg albumin. So introduce that a little later, once the baby is used to eating all kinds of food. And once you note if there is any allergy, you can avoid that. You can go to a doctor, he can tell you. Maybe rash develops, vomiting develops, so that can be related. Many of them must have experienced already. You will be amazed to find that my kid was allergic to jelly. Those jellies used to come, jujubes, if anyone, you all must be knowing. When we were small also, jelly means not the one we make at home, but jelly sweets. So he was allergic to that because it contains agar-agar. Agar-agar is a typical allergen. Actually, it is, we don't know, it could be a sea product also, and many times non-veg is also mixed in that. So we never know. So many food allergies are there, we should be very, very careful. So coming back to the protein part, so see that you give with them high-class proteins, and as I said, even if egg albumin allergy is there, avoid it. If no, egg is the best protein. It has got the highest biological value or highest protein. And suppose you are a vegetarian who is strictly vegetarian, go for soya protein. Because egg protein and soya protein almost have the same value of protein. And then come the milk and milk products, from where you can get a lot of proteins like paneer. So paneer is supposed to be a very good source of protein, so children love paneer. So whoever like paneer can be even given twice or thrice a week. Then comes the sprouts, that is the sprouted, manje mod aleli kadhanya, matki, moog, masoor. Make it a part of the child's diet, not as a breakfast, like we usually for adults, we have it as a breakfast, but put it as a part of their sabzi in the dabba, because usually it is good to carry, it is a little dry with not much gravy, and they will love. Or you can experiment it in the form of sprout bhel. I will not go into recipes now, because then it's going to be a totally different, and Rashmi is very much, you can say she is very good in that, so you can contact her later, because she has once had come across a blog where she had written about a child diet also. It was really good. Secondly, please avoid processed foods and tinned foods as far as possible, because they all contain many preservatives. Even these oats which are plain or rolled oats are best, not the ones which are, you know, like the, what is that called, Rashmi? The masala oats, the safola wala. I don't think they have a very good flavor personally, I just hate them. I would never recommend Maggie also over here, because we all know when we have gone through all the WhatsApp forwards and all the net, please avoid Maggie, it contains a lot of maida. You can go for pasta or noodles which are made from durum wheat, or even you get wheat pasta and wheat noodles also. So you can go for that and try to go for homemade food as far as possible. It's not, I know it is not very much feasible all the time, but try to go for it. I personally go for even homemade pizzas. So I have brought a great change, at least in my house, because my elder one now is, it's not that he's become very health conscious, but he's okay. Once in a month is our outing,
you can say binge day. We don't go very often and they are very comfortable with that. And my younger son is also very, very, like he's in 7th standard, the elder one is in 12th standard. Looking at me, maybe they have become health conscious or they also read a lot. But I think that culture, if it is coming from your own home, will make a difference. It may be your parents, your grandparents who are following it. So that makes a difference. If you yourself will not do that, your children will never do that. Adi kele ani mag sangitle. That is what we say in Marathi. Okay, so it should be like that. Then is the carbohydrate part. Carbs are a greatest source of energy to the brain, the glucose, and a quick source even to the body when the body is very, you can say, tired or deprived of glucose. That's why we give glucose water to, suppose you feel giddy or somebody gets a lot of sweating and tiredness after running. When a marathon running is there, they keep all, you know, like glucose drinks and energy drinks. So that is how the glucose acts. It will give you quick energy. So that also you have to again balance about what type of carbohydrates are you going to give to your babe, the kid. So again, most of them, we go for rice because that is a staple diet. That is a very good source of carb. Yes, rice can be given to the children, but specifically I would say only once a day. Don't give twice a day. Anyway, they go to school. Many of them have dabba walas. I have seen my kids telling me ki unke dabbe wale aate hai, purna varan bhat podi baji sagla asta. But personally I feel do they really need that in school, because they have a lot of exercise, they do a lot of PT, they'll become lethargic postprandial, they will not be able to concentrate in their studies. So avoid giving rice at least in the dabbas. Or you can give something which is very healthy, like veg pulav or dalia ka khichdi, something like that. Not a very heavy meal. That should be avoided in school. So give poli bhaji, or you can give a nice, some healthy meal, like as I said, dalia khichdi. Even sandwiches will do, brown bread sandwiches and all. Again, I'm going to recipes, because we just can't detach ourselves from, when we speak about healthy, you have to give some examples. And then I would come to evening. I think evening dinner is one time when the whole family should come together and eat. Why I'm stressing on this? Because of the today's jo bhagdaud hai, means we all are so busy. I being a doctor, I know that hardly we find time to even interact with our children. At least that is the place for 20 minutes or 15 minutes you are with your children. You will ask them what they have done throughout the day. It will be a very healthy time. We will be exchanging our views. You can discuss on some important topic. Of course, I will also speak Marathi. Madhe vaatta bolavasa karan aple purvaj sangayche ki jevtana bolu nahi. But unfortunately, we cannot follow now, because that is the only time when we all come together. Okay? Then that is one thing I would suggest, that evening should be a nice, maybe it could be for the children. Again, I cook rice in the evening, because that's the only time I feel they should eat. Afternoon, I don't cook rice. And usual pori bhaji. But we can make changes, like parathas, you can cook idlis, dosas, whatever. I usually in the evening, I'm not very much for pori bhaji. We go for a variety of food items. And last but not the least is fats. Fats means essential fatty acids, which ghee is best. So I would say that cow's ghee, or maybe buffalo's milk se banaya hua ghee, the homemade preparation of ghee would be the top priority. Of course, everyone again will not be able to make it, but get it from a good dairy. We have many good dairies in Pune, so you can get from there. But please give more importance to ghee rather than butter, because ghee is supposed to be the purest form, which is giving you the essential amino acids needed for the growth of the brain, because brain growth is very, very important in each child. I will not touch the adolescent part, because it is a different topic altogether. And I think I have stressed a lot on this and a little about fitness. Please give at least 45 minutes to 1 hour of exercise to your kid once he starts going to school. Up to 4 to 5 years, don't even have to tell them, they are super active. You will go mad. I mean, you have to just stop them. But once they start going to school, they will come across a lot of peer pressure, peer talk. They will understand virtual world. They will be glued to the screen. TV toh, I think now will become hits. TV toh dishnar nahi, karan only iPads and mobiles. Please, screen time limit, only I think half to 1 hour in a day. That also, 1 hour tar too much asa, maja mala te mhanta nahi tras hote. But half an hour is more than enough, okay? Because it's very difficult to restrain them, refrain them from the screen time, because everyone is doing it. But exercise. So you can say ki adhi tu 45 minute kai tari khelu ne khali. I would say te kai tari khelu ne peksha. Put them for some physical activity outside, like some taekwondo, karate, swimming. It could be anything. For a girl, it could be dance class, Zumba, anything, Bollywood, whatever they like. But there should be a very good physical activity for 45 minutes. Say that evda karu ne, mummy tula ardha tas mobile var games khelala din, ani ma whatever we, and they will feel hungry and they will eat. So basically, a parent who comes to us and says ki maji mulgi khatas nahi, the answer is this, because the activity is less. Jar physical fitness ani activity asel tar automatic bhook lagnar ani khanar. Okay, so these two things go hand in hand with each other. Once a child is growing, do not neglect the fitness part. It's very, very important. And do not, again, whenever there is a thin girl or a thin daughter or a son, don't say ki ti khat nahi hai, ki mati barik ase. If she is physically fit and she is doing very good in her studies and all other activities, you need not worry. It's not like the olden days ki gubgubit ki maasa chhan baal aslelas baal khub chhan asta gutgutit baal sagrat. No. So now even a lean, fit, lean girl can be also a fit girl. But just remember, healthy diet and fitness. These are the two key words to success. Thank you.